Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're diving into a fairly new application, Hugo Calendar. Now this is an interesting application because it blends calendar, notes and tasks in one place for your team to organize meetings, and it's a really popular trend at the moment in terms of helping people to coordinate meetings. So we're going to dive in. First off, it is apparently used by 30,000 teams. It also has a free forever plan for 10 users and also a fairly high rated Captera score too. This is obviously quite a big trend, calendar apps at the moment, and all of them are doing it in a different way. So it's interesting to see how this works. So here we are with Hugo, and what you can do is sign up through your work account. There are some features that I want to highlight. It does have the likes of Google and Office integration, so Office 365, so hence why you have Microsoft and Google options here. So here we are inside of Hugo. Now, as you can see, it's a dashboard-like experience, and I'm going to show you a few of the features. Let's just zoom in. As you can see, I have a trial at the moment, apparently. The pricing I'll cover near the end of this video, including who this is best suited for. So all in all, the concept behind this is to create meetings and keep track of your notes and tasks. So for example, if I were to select a period of time for a meeting to happen, I could go ahead and create a new event from here. What's good is down here, it syncs with your Google Calendar. And if you had Office 365 or you signed in through your Microsoft account, it naturally would connect up like that. Now, this is what you typically already see inside of an app like Google Calendar or even a calendar app in general. You can add all the sort of regular stuff and even conferencing, which naturally you can do through Google Meet or you can connect it through Zoom. So let's say I had a meeting with the editor. I'm going to put editor and create it. Now, this is where the sort of difference happens for the likes of Hugo. You can see here that you can start out typing a few notes, and those notes could be not just your agenda, but it could even be a campaign plan and everything like that. Like, they've got a few templates to get you started. If I press show more, you can see here that you can actually create your own template, I believe, which might be useful. But in this case, I'm just going to hit apply to the agenda vital. Now, as you can see, it's brought in quite nicely. On this central area, you have where essentially everything you're going to talk about, the topic areas, and down below, you can do a pants test, which is something that they sort of advocate as part of the process. Now, on this right-hand side, what you can actually do is create tasks for yourself and your team, something that's pretty vital when it comes to collaborating. So, for example, I might say, get C21 installed, and press assign, and you can essentially pick people for your team. In this case, I'm going to assign it myself for this demonstration, but you can also give it a due date, even, for example, whether you want to give it to them to do in 1 hour's time, which is quite cool because some other experiences sort of force you to put it on an allocated day, but that actually gives you more granular sort of breakdown. Now, as you can see, you'll be able to see this in more detail later with tasks. You can actually link to your calendar, and you can connect some other applications, and they've got a few on their sort of marketplace. So for example, let's say you connected Confluence, you can create pages from Hugo documents without switching applications, which is quite nice because you sort of take the legwork out of, say, publishing a meeting inside of your existing tool platform. Let's say your Pipedrive integration, you could sync Hugo with against a personal deal. So for example, you could capture the sales pipeline a little bit more effectively. And there's a few applications ranging from Todoist, ClickUp, Zoom, Trello, Slack, etc., and a few referenced there. Now, if I go back to meetings, you can then scrabble through your days ahead. Obviously, I've got this one here, but essentially it's allocated as busy in the calendar. But obviously, you can use one of the other campaign ideas. If you want to preview it first, actually, you can do that quite nicely. I didn't see that before. But you can also insert other fields. Like, for example, they've got their own sort of rich media, video responses, images, and even the ability to record a loom that might be relevant for you and your team. And you can also create a follow-up. So for example, let me go back to this one. Let's say I wanted to create a follow-up meeting. Well, basically it gives me a bit of time to sort of reschedule that. So I could, for example, go, oh, let's follow up on Friday, and I can create that meeting pretty instantly. It's under this nice calendar view over here. Now, I told you I was going to talk about the tasks. The tasks are pretty helpful. You can see here that what you can get is your idea of tasks assigned to you. I thought I assigned myself one, but apparently I didn't. Let's go back and see whether I actually did. I need to press save on this one. I believe then what it will do is it will give me the tasks here. And as you can see, a little bit of a task that I need to do. Not the most beautiful task layout I've seen, but you can see it in context to the meeting notes. And that's pretty helpful when it comes to not missing the context, because that might be quite important. Now, you can create documents in this. So it's sort of slightly like Notion to some extent, but it focuses more on the sort of meeting elements of this. Down here, what you can do is actually go over to templates, and you can start seeing some of the private templates, team templates, and ones that you might see from the Hugo library, which they have a fair few. Now, what they want is to reduce your meeting time, take less time in meetings. And you can see here that I can see any upcoming meetings that I may have for the future, and I can create documents instantaneously. And I can even use a scratch pad here to, well, essentially start writing down some ideas and thoughts. I can also change into this view as well. So that's a little bit of an overview of how Hugo works. Let's touch on their pricing plan. So as you can see, I'm actually on their pro plan, which they automatically assign you for 30 days. But the basic plan, looking at it monthly, you get up to 10 users, unlimited documents, tasks, and doc reactions, private templates, basic integrations. So that's pretty helpful for small teams. But if you wanted to go with the pro plan, it's $8 per user per month, up to 25 users, premium integrations, which you might want to set up. I believe they probably rank their integrations, but based on the complexity of them, and everything inside of basic. And over here, with the business plan, they have to contact sales, but it gives you unlimited users and more calendar insights and more administration abilities. So again, in terms of pricing, this is probably the typical pricing for project management type applications. They sort of assist you in your work, but as you can imagine, the sort of regular setup that you typically get inside of these apps. It's been getting some good ratings. I'd say that one of the things that I was actually quite shocked at is I didn't see this before, but there are seeing these more meeting focused applications popping up. I know there's one like Bellow, and we'll cover a few more here on the channel, but quite interesting in terms of just being able to really bring your team's knowledge into one location. One thing I like about this application that they seem to have done really well is inside of the meetings, is actually having that integration. So if we go to edit, connect up apps, this integrations element is pretty decent, and that actually can really save your team some time, because when you have the meeting, there's that stupid admin, that admin that happens afterwards, like creating to-doist tasks based on it for each person. But if, for example, you and your team connected up a few tasks or your own accounts, what you used, then you might actually find it more beneficial. So sales, marketing might connect up Pipedrive and Todoist. A product manager might connect up Trello and Confluence. A developer might connect up Jira and Slack. You know, it's really, that's, I think, what the sort of killer feature is inside of this application. But again, haven't reviewed as many of these meeting applications, but I'm impressed by this app so far. Anyway, folks, you can check out everything at Hugo Calendar website. We will do some more of these. If you're interested, please do subscribe to Keep Productive. And I look forward to covering more apps in the future. Cheerio, folks.